Well, Candace, you had multiple murders in the city Thursday night, coupled with two separate incidents, as you mentioned, with gunmen taking aim at officers. A few people I spoke with Friday say the violence and lack of respect is out of control. Shortly after a teen was gunned down at the Oliver Crossing Apartments Thursday night, detectives were circling the block early Friday morning. Police say they started taking on gunfire. Crime Insider sources tell me one bullet came through a windshield, injuring an officer with shattered glass. Jared Weish and Niji Harris charged with attempted murder.
I seen all the lights. He said the police in the yard.
Further east and about an hour earlier, shots rang out near Harvey Road.
They found the gun right here.
Crime Insider sources confirm suspected trigger man Wayne Lewis ran from that scene and shot at police officers as he fled. He's been charged with attempted capital murder of a police officer.
When he jumped the gate, I got spotlights on the front of my house, motion detectors. So when he came through, they was coming in the front yard. When the lights came on, he had no choice but to give up.
It's Henrico's 120th shooting incident this year compared to 86 last year at this time. That's nearly a 40% increase. Statistics that have the Fed's attention. Earlier this week, I interviewed Eastern District U.S. Attorney Zachary Terwilliger, who says the influx of violence isn't unnoticed.
We've been sending in federal reinforcements to help the state and locals. You know, a thing like murder is generally a state and local crime. We send in the ATF for their expertise. They're experts at guns and tracing shell casings, and they've been embedded here in the city working hand in glove with RPD and others. That's our goal, because some of those cases will go federal, some will stay local. We want to do whatever it takes to get the violence under control.
And Terwilliger adding that if localities ask, they will make federal crime-fighting resources available. Working for you in downtown Richmond, John Burkett, CBS 6 News.